space shuttle accident. And when I was reporting on it, I said this one sentence on the radio. Nothing to do with the accident. I said that when O'Keefe had walked in...
Hey, it's Dan. Leave me a message.
Hi, honey. It's me. I just got back from the grocery store, and I know it's a little early, but I think I'm going to start on dinner, if that's okay. Text me on your way back. Bye. Hi, Dan. Me again. I forgot to mention in the first message, make sure not to forget the wine. Red or white, I'm not picky, so. See you soon. All right, the table's set. The food is made. Smells pretty good, right? Not that you'd know yet. I'm sure traffic's pretty bad, so I'll just wait until you get back.
I did not find what I expected. I thought there'd be some kind of nationwide government audit. There would be official reports from the election authorities and all the states detailing how they looked for fraud. But there isn't anything like that. In fact, most of the independent studies that have been done are just attempts to count up alleged cases of fraud. They look at court records, news reports, anecdotal accounts, and they never find much. Which is good to know, but it didn't feel like proof. Maybe we aren't looking enough. Right, from all the others. It was an attempt to do this big, looking for one specific kind of voter fraud. To try to see in a couple. The specific type of voter fraud the study looks for is called double voting. Reason people questioning some basic things in their lives they have always taken on faith. Act 3, sun also rises. So among the things I accept as true is the fact that the world. But I have to say there is not a lot to remind you of. Like the ground does feel flat. If you happen to live up in the Arctic though, you are sometimes reminded that we live on this ball that is spinning through space. Our next story is about a researcher named Ian Morrow who went there, way up on top of the Earth, where people still hunt seals and walruses. He was helping make a...
I just left Dan.
Who's Dan?
Dan, my husband. Last night, he didn't come home for dinner, and I made his favorite meal and everything, and I don't even like pork tenderloin, but every time I make quinoa salad, he complains, even though his dad has diabetes, and he knows we're trying to look for healthy alternatives. I mean, what's so great about pork? Anyway, I just had to get out of there. That place is always such a mess. I was always picking up after him. And it's one thing to be a shitty husband, but it's another thing to be a shitty roommate, you know? I am gonna miss his mom, though. She's always such a sweetheart. So I drove all night, and here I am. I just came here to think.
Or talk.
Or talk. Sorry to dump this all out on you. I'm Jolene, by the way.
Glenn.
Nice to meet you, Glenn.
Since we're talking about our days, I also had a pretty eventful day yesterday.
Oh?
I wake up at 6 a.m. sharp.
Oh, shit.
I usually set out my uniform the night before.
Oh, are you a police officer?
Yeah, I work in corrections. I've always been a people person, and as Confucius said, be the change you wish to see in the world. So, here we are. I start the day with a pretty hearty breakfast. You know, I'd eat soup for every meal if I could. But unfortunately, there sure is a lot of sodium in canned soup. Unless it's homemade. I like danishes. Homemade danishes. Blueberry, cherry, brown sugar, cinnamon, you know. Even if I'm in a rush, I always make sure to spend time with Mikey.
Oh, how old is he?
4.
I pack my lunch, usually soup. Friday is split pea, which everyone in the office loves. All that soup means a bunch of recycling. Gotta look out for the environment. And then I cruise to work. Things can get pretty high stakes in my field, even during the commute. I deal with repeat offenders often. You'll never know what kind of stuff they'll get into.
Hey, MJ, what?
Hi, Glenn.
Every case presents a new challenge.
Helping you.
And after all that, I treat myself to a night out around the town. And then, it's off to bed.
Oh, well, that sounds structured.
Hey, it was really nice to meet you, but I actually have a meeting. Repeat offender. Hopefully she shows up.
Well, that's fine. Do you know if there's a laundromat near here?
On 5th. As a man of the law, it is my duty to let you know that people will probably try to steal your things there.
Good to know. Good luck with your delinquent.
Thank you.
Of a reputation. Living in the past.
smoke and watch Halloween Town if you want to come, but it's your call.
Yeah. Wow. Thank you for the offer. I have big plans though.
So I gotta go.
No, thank you.
That'll be $289. How'd you do on that algebra test?
What?
Oh, I just asked how you did on that algebra test. You know, Mr. Jennings, third period. If x equals 5 and y equals 12, why am I going bald at 35?
More like a squared plus b squared equals I wanted to be an actor.
Hey, not to be obtuse, but you're kinda cute. My shift ends at 7. Fuck.
That was a pretty odd interaction. Get it? Like, odd interviews.
Shut the fuck up, Emmy.
Mildred Joy.
Hello, Glenjamin.
Looks like you had a busy day.
It was okay. It was kind of lonely, actually.
You missed our meeting. I made a PowerPoint. I learned how to put videos in it. I had to watch a video to do that, so, listen, it's kind of cold out. Do you want to go inside?
Can we get some more Skittles?
You know, I'm really proud of everything you've done today. You did good.
Thanks. It was nothing.